A very warm day everyone. This is your Valli addressing from SLVM School Jagapatnagaram dealing with the subject English. And children, hope you all are fine and safe at your homes during this corona time and try to wash your hands say always and be healthy, be safe, stay at home. Children, in the previous video, we discussed about parts of speech, noun, pronoun, verb, adverb, adjective. Okay, children, and in this video, we are going to discuss about preposition mainly. And look here, children, I'm going to explain you now the preposition. And what is preposition? Look here, I'm zooming clearly. And what is preposition? Prepositions are verbs. Prepositions are verbs, helping verbs, mostly to link nouns and pronouns with other words. Prepositions are nothing but verbs. What is verb? Verb is nothing but a action word. And what are helping verbs? Helping verbs also verbs, but those are not action words. They describe mainly about the link between the sentences. For example, look here I given the a pictorial description that noun, pronoun, these noun and pronoun are in relationship with other words. What are the other words? Noun, verb, adjective. Clear, children? These noun and pronoun are in relationship with other words like noun, verb, adjective. For example, the cat is sitting. The cat is sitting the table. There is any relation between the cat is sitting and the table? Both are two different sentences. We have to join those sentences by using under. See children, the cat is sitting under the table. Here we have the proper meaning by adding the word under. So the words which can use it to add two nouns or pronoun. Here the cat is a noun, the table is the noun. By adding two or more nouns or pronouns with other words, we have to use these prepositions. I hope the matter is clear here. Now, I'm going with the next topic on prepositions, types of prepositions. Types of preposition. Look here, children, I'm zooming one more time. Here is one more pictorial description that types of prepositions are divided into three types. These types of prepositions are mainly divided into three types depending on situation. Depending on situation. What are those situations? First situation depends on when. When the situation happens. Okay, you all know that we done an excellent annual day in our school, right? So here I'm going to discuss about and I'm taking our annual day as a best example for this preposition topic. Look here, children, here depends and situation is annual day, and here our annual day is when our annual day takes place. Our annual day takes place on January. So the first condition is when. And where our annual day takes place. We celebrated our annual day very happily and very greatly in the backside of our school. So where the annual day taken place? Backside of our school. In which direction? In the sense opposite to our school. So every situation in the preposition mainly we have to discuss in three ways: where the situation happened, when the situation happened, on which direction the situation happened. I hope up to here the matter is clear. Now I am going with the first one: when. Look here, children. Look here clearly. When the situation happens, on which time? When in the sense, on which time the situation may takes place. Here the keywords we may get are in the playground, next on the school, at night, before means before Maasam Pongal, after means after December. We done these things, right? Yes. Why I underlined the three words in, on, at means we will discuss previous on this video. Here example: my birthday falls in January. My birthday falls January. Is there any relation between them without writing the in? No, it does not get the proper relation. So we use the preposition in to get the proper meaning. Clear, children? And the next one is, my vacation ends on Monday. So without writing Monday, there is any relation between them? My vacation ends Monday. Both are different sentences and words. While using the word, we make a sentence. Okay. And the next one is, it gets cold at night. It gets cold. Whether we remove at, is there any proper meaning? It gets cold night. Is there any relation between them? No. Whether we are writing at, we may get the proper meaning. Clear, children? And the next one, what we are going to discuss about the types of prepositions is where the situation takes place. Okay, children, here the keywords are under, above, in, on, at, below, and etc. Look here, children. In, on, at are used for both when and where. So I underlined in, on, at. Okay, children. Now I am going with the examples. The books are on the table. The books are the table. Is there any relation between without, while looking, lifting from on? No. While writing on, we may get the proper meaning. And again the same meanings too. The dog is sitting under the tree. The plane is just below cloud. Okay, children. Now I am going with the next one. In which direction? In which direction? Where to go? Where to put something? That means we take in a... Here I am taking a pen. Here I am taking a pen. I placed my pen here, and after some time I placed my pen here. That means I am moving my front pen from here to here. Clear, children? So that on which direction, where to put a pen or a video or etc. or annual day, we have to discuss about while using prepositions. Look here, children. We went to London last week. Is there any proper relation, proper meaning? No. Whether we writing to, we may get the justice to that meaning. And the next one, he went up the hill. Up is the preposition. Okay, children, I hope you all are clear here. Children, while discussing about in, at, on, I felt that it was a very important topic. So I am giving one more clear information about those by using triangle method for prepositions. Which method? Triangle method. Children, this is not maths. This is our English subject also. I designed a special triangle method to explain you in an easy manner. Look here, children. Here I draw an exam triangle and write first at and on and in the way. And now I'm going to explain some important and some special category words to you about at, on in. Children, don't forget this order. At, on, in. Look here. At is used for specific time. At is the preposition which is used to mention clearly the specific time. That means at 5 o'clock, 5 noon, 5 p.m., 5 a.m. Next, at 12:30. 12:30 p.m. at 12:30 a.m. Next, midnight, at midnight, at 12 noon. Okay, children. Next, on. On is used mainly for explaining about a day and a day. Day and a date. On Monday, on January 25, on New Year's Day, on Christmas Day, on Annual Day, on our school reopening day, on my birthday, on your birthday, on your mother, parents' wedding anniversary. So, this when we have a special days or special date we have to mention, we use the preposition on. And the next one is months, seasons, years, decades, centuries, long periods, we use the preposition in. For months, right? In July. For seasons, in the summer. For years, in 2005, in 2010 and etc. For decades, in the 1960s. For centuries, in the 1800s, in the 2000s, in the 1900s and etc. In the long periods like the past, BC, AC, DC, we have, right? Those types. We may get that AC, BC mainly on social. Okay, children. Here we have few more examples, right? Dash 6. Okay, children. Now I am not going to explain about the examples. Why? Because I am going to give you a task about this topic. So, I will stop about the preposition and continuing the next topic. And here is our next topic. What I am going to explain about in our next topic is conjunctions. What are those conjunctions? Conjunctions are words used to connect sentences, words, phrases and clauses. Here also the same like connecting words like prepositions. But is there any difference between conjunctions and prepositions? Yes. And these are called as connectors. Conjunctions are also called as connectors or linkers. These are also called as linkers. For example, we have some keywords here. Look at the here. And, or, so, but, else, neither, nor, either, or etc. These are the words we already know, right? But we don't know that we call them as conjunctions. Look here, children. We have to call them as conjunctions. Children, look here. He went to the market and his dad went to the cinema. Here, he went to the market is one sentence. And his dad went to the cinema is the another sentence. His dad went to the cinema is the another sentence. While adding these two sentences, he went to the market, his dad went to the cinema, we used the word and. Here, so we call them as connectors. While connecting these two sentences, we used the connector and, so that we called it as connector or linker. Okay, children. Now I am going to the next example. He is neither intelligent nor working. He is not intelligent and also not working. On writing these type of sentences, we use the word neither nor. Next, he is ill. He attended the party. We have to join the two sentences by using but. He is ill. He is not good. But also, he attended the party. Okay, children. Here we have some types, kinds of conjunctions I am going to explain. look here. And the first one is coordinating conjunctions, and the next one is subordinating conjunctions, and the last one is correlative conjunctions. Look here, children, coordinating conjunctions, subordinating conjunctions, correlative conjunctions. Okay, look at here. I'm going with the first one, coordinating conjunctions. These are joining words that join one or more words, phrases, clauses, or sentences. Okay, children, these are also adding words, but those adding words are categorized as but and otherwise, while, so, neither nor, as well as for or else. These are comes under coordinating conjunctions. And the next one is subordinating conjunctions. These words are used to join the dependent or subordinate class. That means here we have some special categories which are going to describe about keywords: time, place, reason, purpose, condition, concession, comparison, result or sequence. We have different types of keywords we are using. Those are also conjunctions, and those lists are given here. I will provide these notes through WhatsApp. And the next one is correlative conjunctions. Correlative conjunctions means here also the same pairing words like both and, as well as either or, neither nor. These are the words we called it as correlative conjunctions. Children, I'm not going as much as deep as preposition in conjunctions. Why? Because prepositions are somewhat a typical topic, but conjunctions are not that much typical. And so I'm not going deep into the conjunctions. I hope you all understand. And I will give the notes through WhatsApp in a very clear and particular manner. Please write the notes very clearly on your notes too. And thank you for watching my video. If you have any doubts, please contact me through WhatsApp. Thank you.